Hey everybody, Joe Lowry, what a day. Happy Thursday, Thirsty Thursday. That's right, one more day until the weekend is upon us. Today, November 2nd. Today is actually National Deviled Egg Day. That's right, folks, that tasteful whores devours, as we like to say, whore devours, whatever it is. The first known print reference referring to the term deviled, actually, or any type of food, appeared in 1786. It was the 19th century that it came to be when used referring to spicy or zesty food, including eggs prepared with mustard, pepper, or other ingredients stuffed in a yolk cavity. So there you have it, folks. Enjoy your deviled egg day. How about Houston Strong, huh, folks? How about them Astros? They beat the Los Angeles Dodgers in a pivotal Game 7 last night by the score of 5-1. What some critics are calling the best World Series ever. I know that's still up for debate. This is the first World Series in franchise history. The Astros took a 2-0 lead in the first inning and never looked back. The World Series MVP went to George Springer, who crushed 5 home runs in the World Series, thus tying Reggie Jackson and Chase Utley for most homers in a series. And I would be remiss if I did not mention that the American League MVP should go to Houston's Jose Altuve. That's right, folks. There you go, Pauly Callahan. I told you I'd mention him. Congrats again to the Houston Astros. And on a side note, in case you missed it, Houston Astros shortstop Carlos Carrera went on live TV and proposed to his girlfriend. And I guess she was Miss Texas USA Daniela Rodriguez. This happened minutes after the final out was recorded. And for the record, she did say yes. How about that? What a story. My only question is, what if they lost? Oh, no. Well, your first place Celtics disposed of the Sacramento Kings last night, 113-86 at the TD Garden. Celtics improved to 6-2 this season, and this came over the broadcast a little while ago. Tony La Russa, the former skipper for the Oakland A's and St. Louis Cardinals, was hired by the Boston Red Sox today. He will serve as vice president and special assistant to the general manager, Dave Dombrowski. Now, there's still no official word on his capacity with those jobs entail, but rumors are swirling around that he no doubt will have a strong say on the certain dealings as well as day-to-day with the organization. By the way, the Red Sox are set to formally announce Houston Astros bench coach, well, now former Houston Astros bench coach, Alex Cora, as the team's 47th manager later on this week. Tonight, the Bruins host the Vegas Knights at the Garden. Puck drops around 7 or 10 or so. And as I mentioned earlier this week in my What a Day show, I sparked a debate on the placement of a cheese on a cheeseburger. Well, this was stemming from a story that the Google emoji had placed the cheese outside the bun as well as on the bottom. Well, the story prompted outrage in Twitterland, causing many tweets about the placement thereof the cheese. Well, Amazon has their cheese placed on the top, and some put it say that was strategic, seeing that CEO Jeff Bezos is now the highest paid billionaire. Interesting. Following backlash on Twitter today, Google CEO Sundar Pichai tweeted he would drop everything to address the debate, clarifying if folks can agree on a correct way to do this, he will help out. However, as of right now, nothing or no changes have happened yet. And YouTube launched a trailer for the movie I, Tonya today that chronicles the story of Nancy Kerrigan and Tonya Harding. Remember that drama that unfolded years ago? And it looks like Margot Robbie's performance as world-class figure skater Tonya Harding deserves a gold medal. Interesting. The trailer brings viewers back to January 1994 when fellow practicing session at the U.S. Figure Skating Championships in Detroit, Stoneham native Chief Harding rival Nancy Kerrigan was hit in the knee with the police baton. Remember that? Well, she was hit by Shane Stant. Now, Kerrigan was forced to withdraw from the competition in which Harding eventually won the gold medal. Harding later pleaded guilty to conspiring to hinder prosecution but avoided jail time. However, Stant, Harding's ex-husband Jeff Galooly, co-conspirator Sean Eckert, and the getaway driver Derek Smith all served jail time, actually prison time, for the attack. I, Tonya will hit the theaters on a limited release capacity on December 8th, and a wide release date has yet to be announced. Well, more North Korea news say. North Korea slammed a Japanese TV station report Thursday that claims hundreds of people were crushed to death when tunnels collapsed at its unstable nuclear site. As reported earlier this week, North Korea prompted the death of 200 people when sections of the tunnel in the North Korea's nuclear site collapsed. This all came to revelation around October 10th. However, the previous report said the testing of the hydrogen bomb over a month ago triggered their collapse. Now, North Korea's state-run Korean Central News Agency said in a statement that a report by Japanese broadcaster Asahi TV was false and merely misinformation. I don't get this. It accused the Japanese station of trying to slander the rogue regime's nuclear weapons program. Pyongyang said that it was it detonated a hydrogen bomb, calling it a perfect success. That was reportedly 10 times more powerful than a nuclear bomb that was dropped in Hiroshima World War II. It has been reported today, though, that there is significant movement in the area indicating yet another missile launch. I don't believe this. Or a hydrogen bomb test from North Korea. Now, the spy agency reporting that North Korea is moving forward with the stabilization of obtaining a nuclear weapon. This is all on the verge of President Donald Trump's trip to Asia, which is upcoming in the next week or so. Unbelievable stuff. We got to stop this guy. Anyways, a nurse can now mark labor and delivery experience down on her resume after she delivered her own baby in her car outside of the hospital that she works in. Yeah, get this, folks. The saga began when Katie Michael and her husband George got stuck in traffic on the way to Pinnacle Health in Parrisburg, Pennsylvania. About 25 to 35 minutes later, her water broke and that she decided she wanted to be there. So what she did was she knew she was going to be born in the car because she started coming out. So sure enough, baby Ella Catherine couldn't wait for her parents to get situated and made her entrance at 5:25 p.m. All this while Dad George was frantically searching for the couple inside as well as getting help. Ella was born weighing 7 pounds, 8 ounces, and both she and Katie are doing well. Well, late news from the NFL today. The Indianapolis Colts have decided to shut down Andrew Luck for the rest of the season. They have officially placed the quarterback on injured reserve. Luck was quoted in saying, "I wish I was 100%, but I am not. But I will become a player from this, and I am excited for the future." No doubt, a crushing blow to the Colts. And finally, folks, you're going to visit my YouTube page, www.youtube.com/JoeLowryWhatADay. It's free. You have to subscribe, tell your friends, family, neighbors, whatever. Anyways, enjoy your thirsty Thursday. Way to go, Houston. Have a great day, everybody. What a day.